Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In today's message, I planned to tell about an invasive candidiasis therapy. However, due to the fact that my approach to the treatment of candidiasis non-invasive genesis cardinally differs from the traditionally used protocols because I take advantage of individually tested nystatin doses, today I will present to your attention the absolutely new approach to therapy of the diseases of internal organs based on the application of especial properties of low-level laser radiation. Photobiomodulation, also known as low-level laser therapy, is the use of red and near-infrared light in the therapy of different conditions. The mechanism of the therapeutic action of low-level lasers have not been received yet a proper explanation, which somewhat restrains the application in medicine. Nevertheless, their favorable impact on health, anti-inflammatory effect, immunity boosting effect, activation of RNA and DNA macromolecules, as well as the absence of adverse effect, are well known. And what is of special importance, the impact is non-invasive. Therefore, the method of laser therapy is promising and requires further research. My first acquaintance with laser medicine took place in the late 90s of the last century, when after many years of application of acupuncture in the therapy of patients, I was trained in laser acupuncture and started applying it along with traditional acupuncture in my medical practice. The very first results have really inspired me, and after a long research, for the first time I learned about the works of International Research Institute for Space Anthropo-ecology, headed at that time by academician of the Russian Academy of Medical Sciences, Professor Kaznacheev. In November 2003, I came to Novosibirsk and shared the problems I have faced with Professor Kaznacheev, namely the difficulty in the therapy of patients with invasive candidiasis. I also informed him on the recently observed tendency of nystatin-tested doses to grow. It means that frequently a single dose exceeds 15 million units of the medication. Professor Kaznacheev in turn proposed the information on some works of the institute headed by him, thanks to which I for the first time learned about the device for remote transfer of properties of a medicine to human body, created by the scientists of their institute. Professor Kaznacheev kindly recommended me to use the patent describing the device, and on arrival to home, I managed to create a similar device. The patent of the Russian Federation is in the open access on the internet. My first experience of application of this device I gained treating the 30-year-old female who has suffered from chronic sepsis and septic pyemia with a constant formation of metastatic phlegmons. The patient's medical history included appendectomy when she was a 5-year-old girl, followed by purulent peritonitis and septic condition. The patient was constantly treated at the National Center for Purulent Surgery under the Health Ministry of Uzbekistan. Almost every month, she was admitted there for incision of the phlegmons formed in various sides of her body. The procedure resulted in removal of up to 1 liter of pus with a strong, unpleasant smell. It is worth saying that the patent offered by me by Professor Kaznacheev was thought to be used of the device for first, for transfer of properties of insulin to patient's body with diabetes mellitus, and second, for transfer of properties of adrenaline to patient's body with head right disorders. The patients were under permanent monitoring with necessary laboratory tests relevant to the studied parameters of these diseases. The light source in the patent is a helium neon laser. However, since I was interested in therapy for infection diseases, which includes invasive candidiasis, after careful analysis, I came to the conclusion to make some changes in the Russian patent. The method of therapy of chronic diseases developed by me is patented. I started applying this technique to the treatment of this patient in June 2004 after obtaining her informed consent. The patient was referred to me by colleagues from the National Center for Purulent Surgery, Surgical Complication of Diabetes Mellitus under the Ministry of Health of Uzbekistan in 1995. I am using the red semiconductor laser with wavelength 650 nanometers and power which is equal to 15 milliwatts. In the picture, you can see the laser device that I use as a light source and the device for remote transfer properties from the medicine to human body. The device contains a drug and a hollow closed cylinder made of non-conductive material. A light guide connected to the light source is spirally turned around the cylinder from the outside and the drug is placed in the inner space of the cylinder. This case has not been described by me earlier in the literature, and for the first time I present it to your attention. The presented photos show the patient's conditions today. Those numerous scars are located practically on the entire surface of her body. The peritoneum, both visceral and parietal, is almost absent. I admire the courage of this woman and her aspiration for life. Probably this fact also has motivated me to do all my best to help her alive and normal life. The therapy has proceeded for 1.5 years and resulted in complete elimination of the infection from the patient's body and termination of the phlegmons formation. Now, some more details about the work. At the prior examination in June 2004, a wound size of 10 to 6 cm was registered in the medial part of the lower right leg. The wound produced purulent discharge with an extremely unpleasant smell. The phlegmon in this area was operated 6 months ago, and since that time it had not granulated. The inflammation was constant and accompanied by the purulent discharge. The patient didn't receive adequate antibiotic therapy due to her financial problems. The bacteriological test of the substance discharge from the wound revealed Proteus infection, Candida species, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, Staphylococcus epidermalis, and Streptococcus species. The patient also had purulent gynecological discharge similar to those from the wound. The body temperature ranged from 38 degrees Celsius to 40 degrees Celsius. At the first stage of the therapy, I have applied triple exposures by the device during 3 weeks. In the course of medicament testing with the use of nozzles, I also revealed the pathogens named above, and I decided to start with destroying Candida species infection. My decision was based on the fact that Candida species is a marker of immunodeficiency and also the factor aggravating the wound condition. Medicament testing was conducted to determine the maximum single dose of nystatin, which was 4 million units of medication. First, the lymphatic system was exposed by placing the device above the projection of the thoracic lymph duct and also on the first and last acupuncture points of the lymphatic system meridian, according to the recommendation of Dr. Wall. Next day, severe pains appeared in the wound that were stopped only by introduction of the large volume of sodium chloride solution lasting 24 hours. The wound became clean within 48 hours. On the presented photo, you can see how the wound looked on the third day after the exposure. Simultaneously, the characteristic of gynecological discharge have changed as well. Purulent discharge disappeared completely and looked like caseous milky substance. The bacteriological test confirmed elimination of Pseudomonas aeruginosa and Proteus infection from the new phlegmons developed in next 3 days on the right back surface, on her hip and the lumbar area, where 1 liter and 1.5 liters of pus were removed after the phlegmon incision, accordingly. But what was interesting was formation of phlegmons and the subsequent period of healing the wounds were much faster, only 2-3 days, and again the background of the significantly easier general condition of the patient. For the next 12 months, the patients had not visited hospital as no one phlegmons developed. The bacteriological test made in April 2005 revealed the presence of Streptococcus viridans in her sputum due to aggravation of chronic obstructive pulmonary disease that I, according to the antibioticogram, treated, placing Abactal into the device. Bacterial identification was done with a Y-TEC system and antimicrobial susceptibility test for different antibiotics, including Abactal, by the disc diffusion method were carried out. In this case, I needed only 2 exposures with the use of a device for transferring the properties of Abactal, after which the patients stopped sputum and restored breathing. Dear colleagues, I introduce you today to a completely new and inherently unique method of destruction of pathogens of various diseases. I do not want to complicate you today with a possible explanation of the mechanism of action of this method. In my next video, I will acquaint you with my own experience of using this method in the treatment of patients with invasive candidiasis and will try to explain how I understand the mechanism of the action of the device proposed for your attention for transferring the properties of a drug into the human body. Thank all of you for your attention and see you soon. Bye.